Reddit, ask me anything. I am the daughter of a billionaire. Ask me anything. Don't want to give away too many details revealing my father's work, but go for it. Have you ever given money to someone just because you overheard from someone or saw in a newspaper or something that they lost their house, or had no medical insurance to cover some expensive treatment, or maybe didn't have enough money to go to college? One time I was in a grocery store and the woman in front of me didn't have enough to pay, so I paid for them and ended up talking to her for a while and found out her husband had passed away and she had 3 young children and was working 2 jobs to make ends meet. I got her information and told my dad, and he hired her as his assistant secretary and gave her full health insurance and makes sure she's home every day to pick up her kids from school. I've never been so proud of my dad than the day he hired her. Do you hide the fact that your father is very rich when meeting new people, or is it just impossible to hide? I can imagine it would come up after very short amounts of time. Thanks for doing this, Emma, by the way. I don't hide it, but I also don't advertise it. It all really depends on the conversation I'm having. If I'm talking about favorite movies with someone, it won't come up as quickly as it would if we were discussing favorite past vacation spots. What's the largest amount of money you can spend at one time without getting in trouble? And what kind of car do you drive? Depends on what I spend it on. In high school, I went on a shopping spree and spent close to $13,000 and got in huge trouble, but I also donated around $10,000 to Nepal and didn't get in any trouble for that. I drive a 2015 Land Rover I got for graduation. Do you ever feel pressured to meet certain expectations because you're so-and-so's daughter? Yes, all the time. What is the weirdest thing your dad has done with his money? He bought a froyo shop, not for profit or anything. He just liked it and bought it. My mom was not pleased. Just to be clear, your father isn't Donald Trump, right? Thankfully, no. Have any of your friendships been destroyed over money? Not until college. I went to a prestigious private school growing up, so everyone had money, so it wasn't a huge aspect in our lives in the sense that it was just commonplace for everyone to have access to the same things. In college, people found out I came from a wealthy family and it would lead to awkward moments like people expecting me to pick up the tab at dinner, or that it was my responsibility to invite everyone to our vacation homes for spring break. You definitely feel used by certain people and you just have to cut them out. Being a busy wealthy businessman, was your father there? Do you have a good relationship with him? He made it a point to be home every night for dinner. Sometimes he would leave and go back to work right after, but that time was very special to me. He also always remembered all my events. Like if I had a lacrosse game, he would ask me about it that night, even thought he couldn't make it. When I was really little, he would wake me up when he got home, make sure I was really awake, then tell me he loved me and tuck me back in. Little things that always made me feel like he loved me and he was doing it all to make sure I was okay. That right there makes you extremely lucky, even if he was broke. I know. I am very lucky and I never forget it. How much do you pay for socks? Do you try to match them with outfits? Do you even wear socks? I wear socks when I work out and I buy them from Target. I think they're $6. How often do you buy new ones? Maybe every 4 months? No clue. Does being part of a rich family change how you think about socks? I think it's a perk of being a person who just doesn't care about socks in general. How big is the house you grew up in? How many cars do your parents own? Private jet? Do you have famous friends? What is your take on Paris Hilton and those goddamn Kardashians? I grew up in a large house, 8 bedrooms, pool house, indoor and outdoor pools, that whole bit. My dad has 4 cars and my mom has 2. Yes, we have a jet that my dad mostly uses for business. Depends on who you think is famous. My dad knows more famous people than I do. I think the Kardashians are brilliant. They took 15 minutes of fame and built an empire. I don't like to judge people too harshly because you don't know them personally. If I met the Hiltons or Kardashians and they weren't pleasant, then I'd have more of an opinion. As for now, they're all laughing their way to the bank. What cars do they have? My dad's main car is Porsche Roadster. Mum's is a G-Wagon. What 5 things would you try to experience if you could be the opposite gender for a day? Peeing in snow. Walking at night without being afraid. taking off my shirt whenever I wanted to. Being able to wake up and walk out of the house without doing my hair or makeup. Probably just wiggling my junk around for a while. Are you religious or spiritual at all? What's your favorite scent for soap? I am not religious. My mom uses a perfume called Flower Bomb and I love it mostly because I love her. How present were your parents in your life growing up? I'd imagine they must have been crazy busy building their business. My dad was busy but always made it home for dinner but did miss a few sporting events. My mom was there for everything. That's really nice. : Are you closer to your mom then? Extremely. She's my best friend. If you had a character in a down and dirty Mortal Kombat style fighting game, what fighting moves would you have? Crouch in a ball and cry. What's your favorite thing you own? My grandma's engagement ring. That's nice. : What about the favorite thing you've bought for yourself? Love bangles. Cool, ask me anything. Thanks. What kind of a financial education did you get from your parents? Did you learn about investing while you were young? Did you have chores to do at home? Or get an allowance? Are you the beneficiary of a trust fund? Or are you entirely financially independent now? About what age are you? In college? Did you get an allowance? Or did your dad expect you to work and learn to make your own money? What is your family's attitude toward charity? Is this something you participated in growing up? I'm sure you're aware of the saying that the first generation makes the money, the second generation spends it, if the third loses it. What generation are you? Have you given much thought to how you want to bring up your kids so that they are not entitled, spoiled brats? I learned about investments from the family accountant in just listening to my dad talk to people. I am the beneficiary. I am 23. I did get an allowance. We are very involved in charities. I am the second. I just want to raise my kids to be good people. Hopefully they'll want to help people on their own. I just hope I get good ones. What one thing rich people can do by that poor people don't know about? My dad loves to get chefs from his favorite restaurants to come to our house and cook. You can get literally any of your favorite foods made for you. I love it. You mentioned a support of Bernie Sanders. How do you feel about income inequality in general? Do others in your environment have similar slash differing views on the subject? I don't have enough unbiased information to form an educated opinion. How large is your closet? Also, what's the most you've personally spent on alcohol drugs in one night? Pretty huge. I spent 7 grand on a night out one time. Has the money had a negative effect on your dating life? When if they find out, of course. Also, how would rate yourself as a driver on a scale from 1-10? I've dated some a-holes who have used me to get in good with my dad, but I am now in a very happy relationship with someone who could care less. I am a 7 driver. Okay. So how many PMs did you receive from people asking money? I think 20. Are you hot? Be honest. I've been told. But, it's all subjective. I'm not wealthy, but I feel like it would make it more difficult for me to connect with people who are of the same socioeconomic status. Simply because I'd always have lingering doubts about their intentions. Do you trust people until they give you a reason not to? Or put up something of a wall and only let people in once they've shown they aren't just in it for free shit? I'm a trusting person, so I usually wait for people to give me a reason to stop trusting them. Honestly, being friends with me doesn't have as many perks as people think. People quickly realize that.